Hi guys, it's Lisa D at Sound Body and Mind. Today's workout is called the Can-Can Arm Buster workout. And the reason why it's called that is because I know that you may be at home with limited or no equipment at all. So this is what we're gonna do. This workout can be done with either no weights at all or head to your pantry and pick up something, cans. Usually you'll find most cans are only like 12 ounces or so, but if you can find soup, this chunky beef soup is 18.8 ounces. It's important that you find two cans that are the same because you don't want your arms to be imbalanced. So cans of soup are great. They're usually like 12 to 18 ounces. It doesn't have to be a can. Trader Joe's, 17 ounces. These are boxed soups. And if you don't have that, you just have some little cans. These are 8 ounces. So 16 ounces is a pound. These are half a pound. 17, 18 ounces is just a little bit more than a pound. Great options. So if you don't have cans, just use your arms, use resistance, and this should be a great workout. So let's get burning. Okay, so here we go, guys. We're gonna start with a nice warm up. Find a chair, sit to the edge of your chair, feet planted nicely on the floor. Deep inhale. And I'm gonna dedicate this playlist to my friend Maggie Knight. So, hey Mags. Deep breath up, bring the palms together, exhale out. One more time, a nice dynamic warm up, get the joints moving, muscles that we're planning on working going. We're gonna roll those shoulders back, posterior rotation. Use the elbows to draw yourself down and back. One more, two more. And then let's do backstroke. Let that hand slide to the edge of the chair. Feel your core as your hand comes back around to your side. Two more. Last one. And then we're gonna bring those shoulders and rotate them forward. Anterior rotation. Hands are cupped like you're swimming butterfly almost. Pull through the water using the chest muscles. Two more. And then we're gonna swim freestyle. Right arm forward and left. Square your shoulders, down and relaxed, pull through. Great for the joints, waking up those shoulder joints. Last one. And then it's almost summertime, so let's swim breaststroke. And every time you bring the arms up, switch the top hand. Okay, so we're gonna go right and left a couple more times. Last one. All right, and then we're just gonna bring those arms all the way up and down, okay? Up and down. Think range of motion. Last one. And then bring the arms right to the side, palms face center, shoulders are down, relaxed. Not up here, in and out. Like you're quietly clapping. And then we're gonna bend the arms and let the opposite arm come up. Right, pull back, and left. Like you're bumping those elbows to the back wall. Couple more, right and left, alternating top arm, last one. All right, arms come down, bring those shoulders up to your ears, make this, close your eyes, don't look at the wrinkles on my face. Anything you need to let go, just punch it up to your shoulders, deep inhale, and then exhale out with the fingers flare, drop your shoulder heads. Let's do that a couple more times. I know we're in some tough times now, but for this next 20 minutes or so, you're with me, and exhale out, maybe better when we're all done. Okay, now just shake out the hands if you're having a little temper tantrum, and then lower down. Right arm is gonna come out in front of you. Take the fingertips, pull the wrist forward, drop your shoulder head down and back, and push the heel of the hand away. Great for carpal tunnel before you get on that keyboard. Other side, and out. All right, let's get going with our cans. Okay guys, so pick up your cans. I'm gonna reach for the chunky beef soup. And I'm gonna tell you something, after we finish this workout, I feel like I've earned a chance to eat these cans of soup. So don't get Vienna sausages, because otherwise you're gonna have to eat them. Let's just wake up the biceps with just some very slow bicep curls in front. Such a lightweight, your feet are planted on the floor. This is the front head of the biceps, and bicep means two. So you've got the short, fat head as you curl up, the long, lean head as you come down. Just gonna wake them up. Four more. Three. Two more. And one. We're gonna take the arms out to the side, getting the outside of Drop the shoulder heads down, curl up and down. Not very hard, guys, we're just waking them up. I promise you it's gonna get harder. Four more. Three, two, and one. Okay, roll the shoulder heads back. Here comes the fun part. Take a nice seat in your chair, get comfortable. Arms are gonna come up 90 degrees. As if there's a table right underneath your armpits, rest the back of the forearms on there. And your can lids are facing front and back of the room. So facing me, drop your shoulder heads. The left arm is holding an isometric contraction, so it's stable. The right arm is gonna open and close. So you're working the back of the shoulder and upper back, and then you're closing with the chest. Let's go eight more like this. Seven, keeping that arm almost at shoulder height. Six, exhale, five, four, three more. Light grip on that hand, two, so you don't put it in the wrist joint, and one. We're gonna keep that right arm out to the side. You're gonna reach up and over, and then pull down and rest that arm on the back of the table right here. Remember, the left arm's just holding a contraction. Let's go eight more. Pull, seven. So what are we working? It's a push motion and a pull. You're working your shoulder and then your lats. Three more. Two. And then we're gonna do a combination where we're gonna close in and out and reach up and down. So we work chest and back, shoulder and lat. Let's go six more like this. Light grip on your can. Four more. Friends, it's starting to get heavy, guys. Three. Reach. You got two more. All right, we're not done. One more. All right, keeping everything up, I want you to turn your palms forward so you can read the labels on the can. Back to the arm. You're gonna press up at the ceiling, like light grip on those cans. Up and down. And down. Let's go four more slow. Three more. Really starting to hit. Two, and one. Hold right here. If you go, we're gonna pulse out two sets of eight. Up, two, three. Put your shoulder hips down and back. Five, six, seven, eight. You're gonna go up again. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Lower down. Put the hands on your lap and extend the arms out long. Reach the arms up and down, roll those shoulder heads back a couple times. All right, we're going to the other side, okay? Palms face each other, back so the arms are on that table. Right arm is in the isometric contraction, left arm is opening and closing. We're doing eight of these. Let's go six more. Five. Four. Okay, try to keep your shoulders and traps from popping up. Three more. So we're not up here, two. And one, we're gonna open up to the side, ready? Reach and pull, up and pull, good. Push up with the shoulder, pull down with the lats. Let's go, six more. Okay, at this point, the right arm's getting pretty tired. Two more, get ready for that combination, in, out, up, down. Ready? Chest, back, shoulder, pull down with the lats. We're doing a total of eight. Six more. Right arm is getting super tie. Five. Feet are planted on the floor. Good. One more. Reach and pull. Really give me a range of motion, like you're actively reaching and pulling. Two more. Right arm is about to collapse. Keep it up there. Don't let it sink. And down. Turn the hands towards you. Lift up first, and then it's a pull down, and then come on up. Pull down. And then press up, pull down, and come up. Let's go four more like this, and then we're gonna up tempo, two sets of eight, three more. You got two, and one. You ready? Come on up, and pull down. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Go again. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Oh. I'm not kidding. Tired. Put the cans down on the floor, arms extend, shoulders are tired. Take that right arm across, sit up nice and straight, shoulders down and across. You're gonna look over your left shoulder, these fingers. Extend the arms out. Left arm's gonna come across, shoulders down, sit up and look over your right shoulder. You're gonna get a shoulder stretch and a rhomboid stretch on the left side of your body. And then face forward, roll those shoulders back. Awesome job. Next move, guys, we're gonna work triceps. So you're gonna take your hands, in your hand, press overhead. These are called skull crushers. So rather than let your shoulders come up to your ears, drop down by widening out the elbows. Your hands are together or apart. This is more challenging apart, okay? You're gonna lower back, and I want you to close the elbows around the temples, okay? That's why these are called skull crushers. We're gonna do 12 of these, so we're going up and down. Press up, up and lower. Pinkies are out, light grip on the weight. All right, we're going 8 more. Get comfortable in your chair. 7, so when you come down, you should feel your elbows touch your temple. 6, all right, I know I added one. 5, 4 more. You've got this. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, keeping the left arm down, only the right arm's gonna go up. Give me 8, unilateral. 7, by himself. Exhale, 6, pinkies out. 5, reach up, 4 more. Elbows facing forward, 3, 2 more. Okay, they're getting tired. And 1, leave that right one down, square out. 8, right here on the left side. 7, pinky out, elbow facing forward, 6. Exhale, 5, when do you breathe? When you're doing the work, 2. And 1. Here's how you come out of the tricep. Come down, open up, roll those shoulders back. Now we're going to do one last set in which we're going to go from a raised position. Remember your option. This is a little easier. This is a little harder. You don't even have to use weights if you don't want to. We're going to accelerate down and then come up, okay? So triceps have to stop that move and then come on back up. We're going to go 8 more like this. And then press up. Remember, keep those skull crushers placed to the temple. You got 6 more. Maybe the hands are touching the back of your shoulder before you go up. 6. 5 more. I know I added one again. 4. 3. Try to relax your neck and shoulders. 2. Make the triceps do the work. And last one. Remember how we come out. And open up. Okay? Next one, we're just gonna make some circles right here. Put those cans, I wanna see your lids. And we're gonna go up and around like you're making a picture frame of the face. Up and around. Going one direction, and then the other. Great work for the shoulders. Up and around. Let's go 4 more round trips. 3. 2 more. And last one. And because I know you're all angels like me, not, okay? Put these cans on your head. Drop your shoulder head. Move the cans about maybe 6 inches in front of your head. And we're gonna make halos up and around. And what is this working? Our lats up the side seams of the body, right underneath the armpits, and upper back as well, okay? Let's go 4 more round trips of your halos. Spread the feet a little bit more to support the low back. You can also feel yourself working your core a bit here. Let's go 3 more. Okay. 2 more. And last one. All right, lower down. Again, quick shoulder stretch. Widen up the feet. Maybe come to the edge of your seat. Right arm comes back, you're touching your left rhomboid on the side. You're gonna tilt to the left and peek to the right. Just look up in that corner. Open up that right shoulder a little bit to get more of a lat stretch. And then square yourself up, extend the arms. Left arm come back, tilt to the right, peek to the left. Bring your left shoulder back. And then square out, roll your shoulders back. All right, last set. All right, this song's for Allison. This one, no weights at all. Arms out to the front. Okay, feet square on the floor, shoulder heads down. All you're gonna do is you've got some cotton balls in your hand and you're just gonna lift and lift. Four sets of eight, seven. Set two, eight. Like you're high-fiving the ceiling, but ever so gently. You need this kind of calm music. Set three. Lengthen your arms, drop your shoulder heads. Last set, eight, six, four more, three, two, and one. Now get your door handles and open them forward and back, forward and back, forward and back. Two sets of eight, eight. Elbows are just slightly bent as you rotate on the front side of your shoulder. Eight more, eight. And back. Seven. Feel your biceps roll to the front. Four more. We're doing awesome. Three. Two more. Keep them up. No rest for the weary. Palms down, shoulder heads down. Pat. Pat. Four sets of eight. Here's set two. Two. How long can your arms be? But keep the tiny bend in the elbow. Don't lock up the elbow. Set three. Three. Two. It's amazing what just resistance does. Last set, guys. Six. Five. Four. We're going to do posterior rotation on the shoulders. A lot of work for those joints. Rotate back and face the palms down. Rotate back and face the palms down. One more on this side. You've got two sets of eight, though. Three. The palms face up, and then they face down. You're going eight more. I know, they're starting to burn. Seven. Six. Okay. Four more. Three. Two. And one. Let's work a little agility. Arm up, shoulder, and out. Switch. You gotta think about this and not ducking your head either. Reach, touch, and out. Let's go four more, two more round trips. Three, two more. Last one, arms in and out, good. In and out, good. Draw and pull, let's get those lats engaged. Four more. Three, two, and one. Face the hands forward, little bend in the elbows, and just press forward. Tiny presses, you should feel your chest. And don't just work the right side, both sides. Eight, seven, two sets, six, five, four, three. Last, eight, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, like magnetic attraction. Elbows up, back, two, three. Drop the shoulder, heads down, forearms are down. You've got eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three. You guys are amazing. And one, lower down. Okay, now we're gonna do something just to stretch everything out. Arms are gonna come in front of you. You're gonna interlace the fingers. You're gonna make little field goals with your thumbs. Drop your shoulder heads back. I learned this from my physical therapist. And pull across. So not up here, drop your shoulder heads down. You're gonna do three on each side. So just pull. You should feel the backs of your forearms pulling out to the sides. Actually your triceps and lower down. Roll the shoulder heads back. You're gonna do that two more times on this side. Arms straight out in front, thumbs up, pull. Okay? And then lower down. Now it's not just the fingers. This should come across all the way across the scapula, the upper back. One more time. Now while we're sitting here, this is gonna feel really weird. I want you to look at your fingers and I want you to see which finger is on top. For me, it's my left one. And then I want you to release the fingers and switch. Now my right one is looking like your left to you is on top. Okay, so this is gonna feel very different. You're gonna really see that one side is always a little more dominant. All right, now pull across and it's probably gonna feel like you don't have as much strength here. So this is something. Drop your shoulder heads and pull. And then lower down. Two more like that. Ready? Sit up nice and straight. Pull. And then last one. Okay? So it's coming from like the backs of the arms as you pull. And then lower down. All right. One deep breath up. Exhale out. And then while we're up here, encircle the right wrist with the left hand and press the ceiling away, but not bringing up the shoulder heads up to the ears. Clamp the feet down, okay? And then tilt to the left and look to the right. Big stretch all the way down the side, right side of that body. And then square out. Circle the left wrist now, shoulder head down. Press the ceiling away. Tilt to the right, look to the left. Bring that left shoulder back a little bit. And then exhale out. Awesome. And then lower down. Roll your shoulder heads back. One last deep breath up. And exhale out. Roll back. Two, three. You guys are awesome. I'm going to go downstairs. I'm going to heat up my soup. And I feel like I deserve two cans of soup today. So have a great day.